Hey there folks, welcome to Wall Street Mojo's investment banking tutorial, and the topic for today is market cap versus enterprise value. Are they same or are they different? Alright, so when we talk about market cap, market capitalization is basically the number of shares outstanding for a company times the value of per share which is being traded, and market cap would fit in the equation for enterprise value. So if you look at the overall enterprise value, market cap can be as a part of, or it is a part of, enterprise value, and enterprise value is the overall value of the firm, and market cap forms a part of an enterprise value. Alright, so now let's look at the website here and see what's given here. Alright, so if you look at the computation here, like what we discussed, you know, the share outstanding is the total number of stocks issued by a company excluding the preferred shares, and the price per share, which you would get on Google, you know, for a particular company. So if you look at the table here, it inundates the market cap of a select few companies, you know, and the companies are given here, and the shares which are outstanding, which is in millions or billions, whatever, you know, and the price of the share, and then it gives you the market cap, which is in billions. Alright, so if you look at the value for Apple or Google, you know, the market cap for them is 591 billion, and for Google it is 539 billion. It is obviously a data which pertains to 2015, but it is just to give you a perspective. Alright, so now let us look at the enterprise value. So enterprise value is nothing but the equity value plus the value of debt, and from that the cash and cash equivalents has to be deducted. Alright, so when you talk about debt and cash equivalents, if you deduct from the overall debt the value of cash and cash equivalents, you would get net debt, and net debt plus the enterprise value or the equity value, which is commonly referred to as the overall picture, is the enterprise value. So that's what's given here. So enterprise value is the market cap plus the debt plus the minority shares plus the preferred equity less cash and cash equivalents, and this whole thing would give you the value of enterprise. Alright, so now let's look at the value for enterprise value for Amazon and try to figure out, you know, what we have discussed. So if you go to this is the Edgar page for Amazon, and if you go to 10Q, you would find the latest reports for the first quarter of 2018. And if you look at the value for cash and cash equivalents, this is in, yeah, so this is $16 billion here, cash, $16 billion cash in hand, and the overall debt is 22, 24, and 48, which is short-term debt and long-term debt, you know, the same. So the overall debt is to the tune of somewhere to the tune of $100 billion less $16 billion would give you the net debt, the value for net debt. Alright, and in that you will have to add the value of equity or the market cap, which would be achieved by multiplying the value of the stock times the shares outstanding. Alright, so the diluted shares outstanding data here is this 490 million shares, and you know, the stock prices, let's try to figure out. So stock Amazon is trading at $1,603. So let's do the math here and we would be through. Alright, so the value of a stock is for Amazon. $1,602.91. Okay, and the number of shares outstanding diluted shares outstanding is 490 million. So 490 million. Alright, and so the market cap would be this times this. Now this data is in millions, so it just means $785 billion. Alright, so this is in millions because this value was in millions, 490. Alright, now let's try to figure out the value of net debt and also look and also see if there is any preferred share. So net debt is going to be the overall debt, which is nothing but the long and short term debt, less the cash and cash equivalents. Alright, so now let us look at the values here. So cash and cash equivalents is $16 billion. And I think the value for the shares outstanding should be 498 because it pertains to 18. I took it for 2017, so there's a mistake here. So 498 is the value, should be the value instead of 490. Alright, so the market cap changes a little bit, but then it has to be correct. Now the overall debt is going to be the total of short term and long term. So long term debt here is this much, so long term debt, short term debt is total current liabilities. So total current liabilities is this much, $48 billion, and the last thing is other long-term liabilities. We will take this into consideration as well, and this is going to be $22 billion. So the overall debt is going to be the sum of all of these three numbers, and the net debt is going to be this less this. So net debt is somewhere to the tune of $78 billion. Alright, now we have already calculated the market cap or the equity value of the company, which is $798 billion, and before calculating the enterprise value I would just look at the value of preferred stock. So there's nothing for preferred stock here, so we are good to go. So the enterprise value would be the total of the market cap and the net debt. So this is going to be the enterprise value. So now let's get back to the website here and look at the equation once more. So what we did just now is we took the market cap here, this particular value, and we took the debt value, and we took the cash and cash equivalents value. and we ignored minority shares and preferred equity because we don't have that. Alright, and that's how we calculate the enterprise value, and we also calculated the market cap. Alright, or market capitalization. So the overall enterprise value of the company is $876 billion. Alright, so I hope you've had fun, and bye for now.